Schistosomiasis is a parasitic disease and is estimated to affect more than 250 million people. It is mostly found in rural poor areas of sub-Saharan Africa. Infection is caused by a flatworm, which is transmitted to humans by snails found in contaminated water. People who live in areas at risk of infection often lack access to sanitation, safe water, and adequate healthcare. If left untreated, the intestinal infections can cause serious health conditions, including liver fibrosis. This tissue scarring can block blood flow to the liver, resulting in high blood pressure and vomiting blood. To provide effective treatment for this disease, we need to understand the risk factors for infection and disease progression. I'm Dr. Goylette Chami, and I lead the SchistoTrack Research Group. We have people coming together from many different areas, from data science to clinical work to ecology. We work at the Nuffield Department of Population Health and the Oxford Big Data Institute. The goal of our research is to better understand schistosomiasis disease progression. One of the ways to untangle complex diseases is by studying the same individuals over many years, which is called a cohort study. A prospective cohort starts to track people before they develop diseases to better understand the timelines of disease progression over the lifetime of an individual. In 2022, we established the SchistoTrack prospective cohort with the Division of Vector-Borne Diseases and Neglected Tropical Diseases at the Uganda Ministry of Health. Large teams across Oxford and Uganda come together to share expertise, set up clinical stations, survey the environment, and work with the local health centers to track schistosomiasis in the most affected communities. We collect important biological, behavioral, and ecological data from nearly 4,500 individuals in rural Ugandan communities each year. With our study design, we are able to answer important questions that may prevent severe disease development and reduce early mortality.
Who is most likely to be infected? And do those people have different mobility patterns than uninfected people?
Why does liver disease develop in some people and not others? Is this due to co-infections with HIV, malaria, hepatitis B, or concurrent alcohol use?
And how can we develop automated tools to help health workers better manage schistosomiasis morbidity in low-resource settings?
By sharing our findings with local communities, our data helps advocate for healthcare facilities, reform treatment guidelines, and increase awareness of the disease. Participants also provide important feedback on how to improve the study design.
We hope that SchistoTrack project will not only help provide guidelines to prevent and treat schistosomiasis-related diseases, but also provide a template for continuously working with local communities to study complex diseases in sub-Saharan Africa.